Hey guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 221. Nikon today has announced the Z9, a new full-frame camera featuring a 45.7-megapixel slack CMOS sensor, a new X-Speed 7 image processing engine, 8K video with extended recording limits, and a complete elimination of a mechanical shutter. The Nikon Z9 will be available to purchase by the end of 2021 for $5,500. Redmi Note 11 series has been officially announced in China. Redmi Note 11 series comes in three variants: Redmi Note 11, Note 11 Pro, and Note 11 Pro Plus. This phone comes with a 120W fast charging support, a 108MP camera, Android 11 OS, and a 120Hz AMOLED display. Redmi Note 11 series price starts at 1,199 Chinese yuan, that is approximately ₹14,000. Please check out the screen to know more about the specifications and features of these three mobiles. Redmi has launched its second generation smartwatch. The Redmi Watch 2 comes with an upgrade over the predecessor. The latest offering packs more sport modes and a longer battery life. And the Redmi Watch 2 is priced at 399 Chinese yuan, that is around ₹4,670 Indian rupees, and is offered in 6 strap colors. Bajaj Auto has launched its biggest Pulsar ever at an event today. The company has launched the Pulsar N250 and Pulsar F250. The new bikes have been built ground up with a new engine and platform. The Pulsar N250 has been priced at ₹1,38,000 by the ex-showroom Delhi, and the Pulsar F250 has been priced at ₹1,40,000 ex-showroom Delhi. The N250 is only available in a single color, techno gray, whereas F250 is available in racing red and techno gray color. Please check out the screen to know more information about these bikes. Poco M4 Pro launch date is for November 9th. The key specifications could include a MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor, Android 11 OS, and a 33W fast charging support. Poco M4 Pro will come as a successor to the Poco M3 Pro. Sony sold over 3.3 million PlayStation 5 consoles in the second financial quarter ended September 30th, and it has now sold over 13.4 million PS5 till date. Shiba Inu hits another all-time high, now more valuable than Adani Enterprises, Tata Steel, and Tech Mahindra. Meme coin Shiba Inu has hit another all-time high of $0.000593 today on October 27th, with its value skyrocketing by over 40% in the last 24 hours. After more than doubling in value over the last 1 week alone, Shiba Inu's market cap now stands at $23.4 billion. This makes the cryptocurrency more valuable than Big Wings, Adani Enterprise, Tata Steel, Tech Mahindra, and others. Lava Agni 5G India launch is slated for November 9. The Lava Agni 5G India price is set for ₹19,990. Details of the RAM and storage configurations remain unknown. We can expect the phone to come with a 6GB and 8GB of RAM with up to 128GB of internal storage. Instagram has announced that it's expanding the link sharing feature in stories to all its users. The company started testing this feature in June and replaced the swipe up links with it in late August. Since the latter was only available to accounts that are verified or have more than 10,000 followers, link stickers will enable more users to share external URLs through stories irrespective of their account's verified status and follower counts. Samsung, India's most trusted smartphone brand, launched an innovative Scan QR feature. To make hassle-free payments in India, the Scan QR feature enables users to make QR code payments by opening the camera or selecting the Scan QR code option from the quick panel. This carrying forward the mission of cashless and digital India, Samsung has customized Scan QR code feature to make it suitable for its users in India. The Scan QR feature is currently live on Samsung Pay compatible devices. Users must have the latest software to experience the Scan QR option. Android 12 L has been announced by Google. Purpose-built for larger screens, the new UI is more refined and brings tweaks across elements such as notification, quick settings, lock screen, overview, home screen, and many more. For instance, on a display size above 600 dpi, the notification shade, lock screen, and other system surfaces uses a new two-column layout to take advantage of the screen extra real estate. This update will be released early next year, and the tech giant is working on OEM partners to bring the new update. Google confirms this Android 12L developer preview will first arrive on Lenovo Tab P12 Pro, and that Google is currently focusing on the tablets, foldables, and Chrome OS devices. It later plans to open up Android beta enrollments for Pixel devices as well. Battleground Mobile India is hosting a Dune-themed experience in the Evoground mode. The BGMI X Dune crossover will be running until November 11th. The Evoground rewards feature Dune Pan and Dune Parachute. Truecaller stated that it is working with the IRCTC to offer greater trust in communication. This essentially means that you are calling a verified helpline number on the Indian Railways. Users calling the railway helpline number, which is 139, will now see a green color tick next to it. According to the stat, the 139 Indian Railway helpline number is used by millions of passengers for a variety of queries. IRCTC started the 139 inquiry and helpline services in 2007 with Bharat BPO Service and Limited as a technical partner in the project. 12th generation Intel Core Alder Lake processor have been announced. This lineup is led by the flagship Core i9 CPU that is claimed to be the world's best gaming processor. Intel is promising an average performance improvement of up to 19% with the 12th generation processor over the 11th generation. Realme 9 series of smartphones and a Pro variant in the GT series are reportedly in the works. Realme 9i, Realme 9 Pro Plus and the Realme GT 2 Pro have today been spotted on the Eurasian EEC certification website. This device could launch sometime in Q1 2022. During today's Redmi Note Focused event, Liu Weibing, general manager of the Redmi brand, revealed that the Redmi Note series has sold over 240 million units globally. It seems that things have been moving pretty faster since May when the number stood at 200 million. Before that, it was 140 million in November last year and 100 million in October of 2019. So in the last 5 months, Xiaomi managed to sell over 40 million units, that's an 8 million a month on an average.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.